500-year anniversary celebrations. And we're also delighted to welcome the Keiskamma Music Academy, who are on a whirlwind tour of the UK, I understand, having been to Manchester and Birmingham, among other places. So just a little bit about the tapestry. I should just say Linda Luxon, our former treasurer, and Dr. Carol Hoffmauer, who will be speaking a little bit later, have really been instrumental in getting this going. And Keibu Mbubu has been the artist who's with a large team of people who's created it. And as you can see, it's based on some very key images from our history, from William Harvey, King Henry VIII, Thomas Lineker, etc., our building that we're in today. Just a few words about the Royal College of Physicians. We are, as I've said now, almost 500 years old. We were founded by King Henry. I have changed the wording here a little bit. I've said to regulate the practice of medicine and ensure high standards. Julie, who gave me this little crib, thought slightly about stopping all the quacks and naughtiness that was going on. 500 years later, we remain committed to these high standards and to supporting the delivery of the highest quality of care and healthcare for everybody. And we do a lot of work in terms of curricula, examinations, standards, clinical guidelines, etc. And we've also had a very, in the last 50, 60 years, and in fact you could say going back to Thomas Lineker's time, involvement in public health, issues like smoking, obesity, air quality, and in fact on Thursday, tomorrow night, if you want to come back, we've got a very nice talk on air pollution. That was just a very quick try. So I think the format now, I will stop speaking. We're going to hear some wonderful music and then one or two small speeches afterwards. So over to you guys. I don't know if you're ready to go, but that would be super. Thank you.
glasses on. So I usually have two, one on my head for distance and one here to read. It's a miracle to me to have us and the young people from Keiskamma Music Academy in this RCP building. If you knew, and some of you, a lot of you do, know the place we come from, you would appreciate the miracle that is unfolding in front of us. We've also come with my colleague Sebo Mbubu from Bodiam Village, which is just up the road from Hamburg. And it's appropriate to be in this building, which I've grown to love over the time we were researching the building, because I want to speak about healing. Since the Keiskamma Trust was started in 2000, it's been my firm belief, as Arundhati Roy phrases it, to mend a shattered world, we need to build connections between people. This event and all the work of Keiskamma is a miracle because countless people from many different places all over the world and many people in our rural villages have included themselves in this particular story of healing. I can't mention everyone because there are far, far too many, but I believe because of these connections, a miracle, a tapestry of transformation and healing has spread from a small, neglected, disadvantaged, broken place in the Eastern Cape to places all over the world. And just in passing, I am always surprised to go into homes of people and find our work spread from one end of the world, actually, to the other. And this has happened as people have joined us and given their own unique gifts and care to us. I do want to mention only two people in our past history, and that is Jan Chalmers, who's here with her husband Ian, and Jackie Jasuski, who couldn't be with us, because they were there from the very beginning. And they were the first to take a leap of faith in a venture that not many people could believe in, and come for over 10 years, once or twice a year, to teach embroidery stitches. The first part of our project was an embroidery project. And without them, our embroidery would never have reached the level that it did. Now, today, in December 2017, it was also made possible by some kinds of unique connections. Seemingly, they were followed randomly, often blindly, and in my case, often tearfully. Keith and Penny McAdam first found me with an abscess on my nose in a rural clinic near Hamburg trying to heal others, something like the plank of wood and the moat of dust. They connected us with Richard, Duke of Buccleuch, who has just walked in the door on cue. who, if you can believe it, our young people spent last night in Barton House, hoping to be lost there and stay forever. So Keith and Penny and Richard pushed and paid and carried on pushing to help us to be invited to make this work. Professor Linda Luxon, then treasurer of the Royal College, put herself on the line for us. Just as Dennis Lasden said of the college president, Sir Robert Platt, at the time when he decided to go with Lasden's plans for this very audacious building, he said that it was a monumental leap of faith that Robert Platt took in deciding to use this building. And in maybe a lesser way, but I think Linda took a monumental leap of faith in letting a small group from Hamburg down a very dusty road dare to make a piece for the Royal College 500th anniversary. So I would like to thank Keith and Penny for this work, Richard, And of course, Julie Beckwith, who has stood alongside us and sent us pictures when we needed, and is always available for advice, for you, for your faith in us, and for making this possible. Together, we are all healing a shattered world. I also have something to say about the artwork. Should I say it now? Just before Sebo, I introduced Sebo. The art and craft work that you see here, and the music, because Max hasn't spoken, is part of a collaboration with a group of Naro San people who live in the Kalahari in Botswana, over 2,000 kilometers from where we live on the coast. And we have for many years collaborated with them on with the artworks, and these banners that you see are their designs. They are painters and printmakers, and some of the cushions are designed from their designs. This year, we started for the first time a music collaboration, and some of our musicians visited there, and some of the composers, and some of the music that they're playing on this tour is a collaboration, and some of the donations and the profit on the cushions that we sell of theirs goes back to the Kuru project in Botswana. Now I want to introduce my colleague Tsebo Mvuba, and he and I have worked together for over 16 years. He has a degree in fine art through the project, and he has really taken over from me as I get closer to retirement for overseeing and directing all our major artworks, which he did with this artwork. And not only directed it, but he also, a lot of the finer embroidery on the faces of the portraits, he did himself, because he's also the best embroiderer in the project. He will just introduce himself, and thank you.
So I was one who oversaw this artwork. You know, when I was young at primary school, boys, they used to learn woodwork, and then women, they used to learn sewing. I find out it was 2001 when I joined Keiskamma Art Project that I've got a talent of sewing. So I started learning embroidery. But I joined because I was helping them to do drawings. So from then I've learned how to embroider. Jackie, she's one of the first teachers who taught us embroidery. So one of the pieces on the sides, all these small portraits, they were done by me when I was there. I've done it myself. I've drawn them, and then I've done also the embroidery. And then there were also people that were more involved, like the embroiderers. Most women and few men. In my village, most of men, they don't like embroidery. I think it's because of that. Because when we were at school, boys, they know that they are doing good work, and then ladies are doing that. And then there's still that mentality. Even today, people are just asking me, what are you doing there? Because it's only women. So, but this is the answer of that. This is what I'm doing. We really, really appreciate this opportunity of doing this commission for this Royal College. And then I think for me, it was a privilege to be here and see where it helps. Because sometimes you just do things and then you just send them. But thank you very much for the ones who supported us to get this commission.
It wasn't much of a leap of faith. Look at the magnificent masterpiece we've got, and I saw the beautiful tapestries that you'd made in Hamburg, and I think you are just magnificent as well. I have to say, we're not used to such jollification in the college. I definitely something we should progress. I think it's wonderful. Thank you all so much for coming, and I think it's really brilliant that we're able to celebrate with our international colleagues and friends, because we have many international doctors around the globe, and it was a real privilege and joy for me to go to Hamburg and see something totally different And I know many of your mothers have contributed to this, so that also is wonderful. So thank you for coming, and thank you for livening up our 500-year celebration. You'll certainly be remembered, and certainly Hamburg will have a very special place in the college henceforth. So wonderful to see you here. Come again soon. We need more of this sort of thing. Thank you.